This is the Upper San Francisco Estuary. We're out here today on Arnold Slough in the Suisun Marsh. And it's a location where we are doing an experiment to see how fast juvenile salmon grow. Salmon hatch as eggs up in the rivers. And then from that point, they have about 3 or 4 months before they hit the ocean where they have to grow really fast. And if they don't grow fast enough, they get eaten by bigger fish. So essentially, good habitat is a place where fish grow faster. We put the salmon in these cages 5 weeks ago, and every single salmon has a little pet chip in it, so we can track individuals. We have a little scanner, and our plan was to come out every 2 weeks and measure how much they've grown, and then we measure the water temperatures, we see how many bugs are out there, and then we can get a better idea of what's going on. That's the reason why some fish are growing faster in some places than others. We lift the cages up out of the water and net them out of the cage, and we take pictures of them on a measuring board. And then on the computers later on in the office, we can figure out how much they weigh just by the dimensions of their body. Originally, the study was going to be 8 or 9 weeks long. After 2 weeks, COVID happened. We decided we would protect all the crew by having no one go out. We just left the fish out here. Now it's been 4 weeks, and we're going to pull the fish out and get the extra data and end the experiment. So what our crew is doing, they stayed on quarantine for 3 weeks, and then anyone who had not become sick was able to volunteer for a set crew. They won't intermingle with any other crews, and they got their own boat, their own equipment. They're trying to distance themselves on the boat, which is difficult when you're working, and they're wearing masks and protective gloves. So that we're doing everything we can to minimize the spread. There's a couple of reasons why it was really important for us to make it out here. We want to get these cages out because we don't want them to become some kind of a boating hazard. The other reason is this information is really critical for making decisions for managing water and for managing habitat restoration and informing actions to save salmon in general. We need to have information on all these different kinds of habitat. How fish grow is one of the main things that we don't understand about habitat. And so if we can plug that into the model, it's going to really help us pinpoint and target the kind of actions that we do to save salmon.